Hello, I'm Reece Jones, and welcome to this sleep talk down and lucid dream incubation recording. Today, I'll be guiding you through the process of relaxing your mind, preparing yourself for sleep, and then, once your mind space has been softened, sowing the seeds for a lucid dream later on in the night. In this particular recording, the sleep talk down theme will be imagery distraction, and the lucid dream incubation theme will be a trek through a dream maze. Please note, you're free to fall asleep at any part of this recording, so when you begin to feel tired, don't hesitate to follow that feeling. If that happens during the sleep talk down, that's fine. If it doesn't happen until the lucid dream incubation, that's also fine. First and foremost, prioritize falling to sleep. Do not wait for my permission to do so. Follow my words until you begin to feel drowsy, at which point, allow yourself to let go and gently drift away. And so, to begin, please turn off all of your lights. Lay down on your bed and get into a position that you feel comfortable with, be it on your belly, on your side, or on your back. Whichever position you feel most comfortable in, adopt it now. And then, make any final adjustments you need in order to feel fully settled. For example, perhaps you'd like to fluff your pillow, or maybe you'd like to stretch your legs and then snuggle into your comforter nice and tight. Whatever makes you feel cozy is fine and should be done now. If you haven't already, you should now close your eyes and take a deep breath in and out, and another deep breath in and out. Then allow your breath to settle into a normal rhythm, not forcing it to go one way or another. Today, we're going to experiment with a technique called imagery distraction. This is essentially a way of occupying the mind with pleasant, relaxing thoughts in place of worries and concerns. It was proven to be a highly effective technique when, in a 2002 study, sleep scientists demonstrated that engaging in this practice not only brought on sleep more quickly for insomniacs, but also for the population at large. And so, we're going to give exactly that a spin today. Before we begin though, I want to give you another minute or two to settle in here. So let's take another deep breath in and out, and another deep breath in and out. And now, rest your attention on the breath, and allow yourself to relax fully into the moment. And so, as my voice returns, allow yourself to now pivot your attention to the visualization exercise. To begin, I want you to first decide on exactly what you're going to visualize. It should be a place or an environment that makes you feel calm, relaxed, and at ease. It could be anything, and what you choose will be dependent on you and your history. Perhaps it will be your childhood home. Or maybe it will be an exotic beach. Perhaps a library. Like I said, it really could be anything. So take a minute here now to trawl through your memory banks and find a place or an environment that makes you feel calm, relaxed, and at ease. Okay, so now you should have something in mind. And from here, I want you to begin actively engaging with the visualization. In other words, allow your mind to explore the environment that you've settled on. Engage your senses with it. Look around the space. What do you see? If you're in your childhood home, perhaps you see your mother making a lovely home-cooked meal. And what do you hear? For example, if you're on a beach, perhaps you hear the soft lapping of the waves. And how does the environment feel? As in physical touch. If you're in a library, perhaps you feel the spine of one of the books, or flick through some of the pages. Wherever you are, and whatever you're experiencing, allow your mind to fully explore it now. And as your mind continues to explore this visualization, notice how your sense of safety is increasing. You feel your well-being heightening. You feel good here, and you feel fully engaged with what's unfolding. So continue exploring this visualization for another minute or two, and feel yourself inching closer and closer to sleep as you do. And remember, if you feel ready to drift off now, don't hesitate to do exactly that. Whenever you're ready for sleep, allow yourself to follow that feeling. You are now in a supremely relaxed state, either sleeping or on the edge of sleeping, and so we're ready to begin incubating a lucid dream for later on in the night. By following along with my words and visualizing them as you go, you'll prime yourself to draw upon these very same images during REM. There's no need to follow along strictly, just continue relaxing and allow my words to wash over you. Whatever images come, come. And even if you're now asleep, know that your subconscious will soak these words in and store them for later. So, let's begin. You come to on the edge of a maze, sitting cross-legged on the floor, looking at the entrance. You're feeling spacey, and the entrance reflects that. It's shifting and morphing, and this makes you question where you are. What is this? You think, trying to nail down your whereabouts. You trawl through your memory banks for where you were 15 minutes ago, but come up with nothing. What about 10 minutes ago? Still nothing. 5 minutes ago? The same. You have literally zero memory of how you got here, and this raises your suspicions even further. This doesn't make any sense, you think. You look back to the maze and see a sign hanging above the entrance. The Mind Maze, it reads. The text is shifting and morphing, and when you look away, then look back again, it's changed. The Dream Maze, it reads this time. And with that, the penny finally drops. I'm dreaming, you say out loud, immediately getting to stabilizing the scene and clarifying your thoughts. Your lucidity is clear and unwavering. The scene is stable and solid. And so, you now turn your mind to what you want to do within the dreamscape. You had something planned, just like all good and aeronauts do. But now that you see this maze, right in front of you like this, you feel compelled to explore it. It's calling out to you, and so you do not resist its pull. What lurks within, you wonder, walking over to the entrance and taking your first step in. As you enter, the walls stretch up towards the sky, enveloping your vision. Of course, there's nothing stopping you from simply walking through these walls. Within a lucid dream, this is certainly possible. But you decide against it, curious to play the game the dreamscape has laid out for you. And so you begin to explore the maze. First you go right, then you go left, continuing on, hitting a fork in the road, then a dead end, getting deeper and deeper into the labyrinth. You're now in the belly of the maze, and you sense the centaur drawing closer. But you can't quite figure out the final way through. You've backtracked a few times now, and once again are at the same spot you were at just minutes prior. "Show me the way," you say out loud to the dreamscape. And in response to your request, you're hurtled 10 feet up into the air, onto the top of the maze. You now have a bird's eye view. In the center, you see a great furnace, ablaze with a vibrant orange light. You focus on it and notice that the environment around it is vibrating and splintering. What is that thing? You wonder, intrigued. More than ever, you want to get to it. And so, taking a quick look at the final section and transferring it to memory, you drop back down into the maze and venture through the remaining section. upon finally reaching the center, you're greeted by an awe-inspiring sight. What looked like a furnace from afar now reveals itself in actuality to be a small, spinning sun. You're immediately struck by a heady mix of emotions as you take a few tentative steps towards it. A great warmth hits you. A warmth that not only warms your body, but also somehow warms your mind, setting your imagination ablaze with great images of your past. Your childhood home. A day on the beach with your family. A busy night spent revising in a college library. It's as if the sun is talking to you, unlocking the maze within your own mind and revealing key moments of your past in the process. "It's beautiful," you say, taking one last step into the sun's radiant, shimmering aura, your eyes welling up with tears as you do. And so, in the final moments of the dream, you're consumed, merging with the essence of the sun as you give yourself over to it, completely sacrificing your sense of self in order to return to the whole. "Thank you," you say. "Thank you for reminding me." You have now successfully planted the seeds for a lucid dream later on in the night, and have primed yourself to recognize it as such when it occurs. You're now also in a state of supreme relaxation, fully at ease, either sleeping or just now ready to begin the first phase of sleeping. And so, with that, I draw this session to a close. Remember, you are a lucid dream.